The Aura Linda text, an ancient manuscript, a book that refutes what we know about our world's history. In 1876, a very strange book dated from the 13th century, specifically in 1256 AD, appeared in London, England. The original text was written in the Frisian language. It's an ancient Dutch dialect that's very similar to ancient Greek and spoke on historical, mythological, and religious topics. And according to the writings, Europe and other regions were ruled by female priestesses who worshipped the goddess Freya. And still in the manuscript, its authors claim that this culture used an alphabet on which the Phoenician and Greek alphabets were based. Experts explain that if and when the book is authentic, then it must have been written by many people in a period 2194 BC and 803 AD. And this is what the alphabet looks like. As you can see, it has a lot of Greek characteristics. Now, in addition, the book was about a large island in Northern Europe, probably Atlantis, so it was before the sinking of Atlantis, inhabited by a highly developed tribe in 2193 BC, but the island was destroyed after a great catastrophe, and the date that coincides with the biblical catastrophe of the world and Noah's Ark. And those who managed to escape migrated to Egypt, Greece, and Crete. Kindly support my Patreon account since YouTube has again demonetized my YouTube channel. The daily posts are 5 videos daily, and they are totally different from what I have on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for your support and that you find all my content so interesting. You'll find the Patreon account details in the description box below. So this is what it refers to, the very act of the event of the Great Flood, Noah's Ark, and the flooding of the earth and the sinking of various areas, especially the sinking of Atlantis, which is now lost. We know that even the island of Rhodes was going up and down in that flood, but Rhodes stayed up. Even though it was sunk, it stayed up. You can imagine the tremendous amount of geologic activity that was going on there. And the people that escaped migrated to Egypt, Greece, and Crete along the Mediterranean. So the Aura Linda book that refutes what we know about the world history, it's logical for the book to provoke a storm of reactions as to its authenticity, because the historical facts it mentions are different from what we knew until then. The anachronisms on various subjects do not enhance the authenticity of this. Studies have shown that the paper on which the original was written comes from Maastricht around the year 1850 AD. So the paper itself shows that it was recently made. So anyway, we don't know if it was copied from another more ancient script. Of course, all this skepticism did not prevent some politicians and historians from using it to their advantage. In particular, many of those of Germany in the middle of the last century, their theories on what the book said, perhaps because most of the cultures, according to the book, came from Northern Europeans. But to this day, there's no clear evidence for the falsity of the book, which in case of authenticity, invalidates what we know so far through the Bible and world history, according to various historians. Now, the Aura Linda book, written in the form of Old Frisian, purported to cover historical, mythological, religious themes. The Old Frisian, as we know, is the West Germanic language spoken between 8th and 16th centuries in the area between the Rhine and the Weser of the European North Sea coast. Nevertheless, public controversy revived the context of the occultism of Europe, and the book is still occasionally brought up in esotericism and Atlantis literature. And the manuscript's author is not known with certainty, hence it's unknown whether the intention was to produce a pseudographical hoax or a parody, or simply an exercise in poetic fantasy. Now, the contents, Themes running through the Oralinda book include catastrophism, matriarchy, mythology. The text alleges that Europe and other lands were for a large part of their history ruled by succession of folk mothers presiding over a hierarchical order of celibate priestesses dedicated to the goddess Freya. And we know Freya from the Vikings as well. Freya is a reconstructed name or epithet of the hypothetical common Germanic love goddess. Now, daughter, she was the daughter of the creator god Wur-Alda and Yurtha, the Earth Mother. Oh, that's Earth, Yurtha. That's Earth. Earth is also hearts in Aramaic. Now, the claim is also made that this Frisian civilization possessed an alphabet that was the ancestor of the Greek or Phoenician alphabets, and modern historiography is essentially ignored, particularly in the area of the basic chronology of known events in ancient and distant past of Europe. Geologically as well as geographically, evidence that was readily available even as far back as over de Linden's time is also mostly absent from this manuscript. The earliest portion, as we said, of the Oralinda book, namely Freya's text, is supposedly composed 2194 BC, whereas the most recent part, the letter of Hide Oralinda, dates to 1256 AD. Almost half of the entire book comprises the book of Adela's followers. The original text around which the rest grew is purported to have been compiled in the 6th century BC from a mixture of contemporary writings and ancient inscriptions. And the last two sections of the Oralinda book contain a number of lacunae. Lacunae are a gap in manuscript inscription texts. So there's gaps missing. And the book itself breaks off in mid-sentence. It also describes, as we said, the land called Atland, the land of Atlantis, which was supposedly submerged in 2194 BC, the same year as the 19th century Dutch and Frisian almanacs, following traditional biblical chronology given for Noah's flood, the great flood, the deluge, as we know. This is from a Greek article, and I'll leave a link below, and also from Wikipedia on Oralinda books. Thank you for your comments and your support. Thank you.